First up, though, shocking revelations have been made by the Islamabad High Court judge Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui while he was addressing the Rawalpindi Bar Association. He says that the Inter-Services Intelligence, or ISI, is involved in manipulating the judicial process in Pakistan and has completely taken over the judiciary. Justice Siddiqui went on to say that the ISI gets its desired benches made in the judiciary and gets the cases marked as per their wishes. He also said that Islamabad's High Court's Chief Justice was told to not let Nawaz Sharif and Maryam Nawaz out on bail before the elections by the ISI. And on the broadcast live with me from Pakistan is our bureau chief there, Anas Malik. Anas, thank you for joining us this afternoon. These are some pretty damning statements that Justice Siddiqui has made. Before I ask you about the nature of those allegations, just take us through what happened, who he was addressing, and what all he has said.
Absolutely, Aisha. These are very damning revelations that are coming in from Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui of the Islamabad High Court. He was addressing the Rawalpindi Bar Association earlier this morning around 11 a.m. local time. He had been invited by the Bar Association there to address the lawyers there, and there was a huge presence of media. Now, what is to be noted that Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui has been the controversial figure of late. He was the same person who had acquitted the murderer of Salman Taseer, former governor of Punjab in Pakistan, from the terrorism charges, despite the fact that Mumtaz Qadri had time and again admitted that it was a premeditated murder and it was well planned. So Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui, and recently in one of his statements as well, he had went on to say that the National Database Authority of Pakistan, that maintains the database and issues the nationalities and the CNICs, it also has to specify the religion of the people. So Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui has been a controversial figure in Pakistan's judicial scene since a while. Now, these are very serious allegations that have been coming in from him. And what also has to be noted that he's already in question. He's already facing a corruption reference against him in the Supreme Judicial Council of the Supreme Court. So he going on record just before the hearing of that reference at a public forum, alleging that that the ISI has a lot to do in Pakistan's judicial scene at this point of time. They've taken over it. The whole judicial process is manipulated. Not just that, he's also said on record that the accountability court that heard the appeals of Nawaz Sharif and the corruption references against the Sharif family, they were to report to the ISI officials every evening.
Right.
And also he's went on to claim that he knows that how the judicial process has been manipulated, how the ISI gets its desired cases checked. The Islamabad High Court Chief Justice was particularly instructed by the ISI that there should be a bench that would exclude Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui, and that Maryam Nawaz and Nawaz Sharif should not be put out on bail in LIU of the request that was put forward by the judgment they had challenged.
Allow me to come in, Anas. I just want to ask you about that last bit that he talks about Maryam Nawaz and Nawaz Siddiqui's bail application, that it should be rejected before the elections. I mean, we're what, 4 days away from the country going to the polls. What sort of impact do you think this statement is going to have? Are you expecting certain voices to speak up? We know that the army has been repeatedly clearing its name as far as its involvement in the election process goes. Can we expect a statement in a day or two, if not sooner?
Just before I answer your question, just a slight correction. These applications were not rejected. They were postponed. The hearing of these applications were postponed. So technically, it's still in pending. And that is the exact point what Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui has made while addressing to the Rawalpindi Bar Association, that the Chief Justice of Islamabad High Court, he was influenced and he was told by the ISI officials that Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui should not be made part of the bench that is hearing that is to hear Nawaz Sharif's review petition. So just a technical point, that Nawaz Sharif's review petition said that until the review is complete, he should be made to put out in jail. It has been postponed, and now we saw that the two-member bench, their vacations were cancelled by the Islamabad High Court. So it's all technically manipulated, as we say here in Pakistan. Now the impact of Nawaz Sharif getting out of jail and running the elections, just running their election campaign, would have been huge, because right. As of now, the momentum that Nawaz Sharif and Maryam Nawaz had in their jalsas, in their public gatherings, that is what PMLN has been able to gather, despite the fact that Nawaz Sharif's brother Shehbaz Sharif has been running their election campaign. But that momentum, that zeal, that enthusiasm has been clearly missing. So obviously, if just in case Nawaz Sharif and Maryam Nawaz would have been granted bail, the tides would have definitely changed. Yes.
All right, Anas, it's a big revelation, as you've said, a big allegation that's come our way from Justice Siddiqui. We'll keep track of that story for now. Thank you very much for bringing us that perspective from Pakistan. We'll, of course, touch base with Anas as and when more updates come in on that story.